count, VTR 216-74, take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean. Brett Sauer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. Play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
How are you?
Just fine. You are a vision.
I thank you.
And I've been eating mushrooms.
And they're going to your head there. Is everyone ready and okay?
My nails are still wet.
Your nails are still wet?
Don't touch me. I'm sticky.
May I blow on your hand?
She'll okay. Do anything.
Your nails
she?
Are dry. Yes. All right.
Well, she married Alan Ludden. I guess that's Libby Brooks. She'll do that.
Biz. That's it. Listen, we've got beautiful celebrities here, and we've been having a marvelous time with them all week long. Now let's say hello to our beautiful contestants, Chris Lyons and Margaret Moore.
Hello, ladies. Where are we? We finished round one, right?
At the end of round one, it's 5-0 in favor of the champ, and we're going to go to round two in a moment or so. Margaret has won $5,600, being challenged by Chris, but Chris didn't do too well in the first round, but she hopes to do better in the second round,
oh,
right?
Yeah, for sure.
All right, we'll see how that second round turns out. Right after we find out. Here we go with round two, our final round in this game. Chris, would you please make a selection?
A.
She wants A. Good luck to both ladies. Everybody
a
plays.
A Cadillac, a diamond.
Tiny Willie Shoemaker got so mad.
Tiny Willie did?
Yes, he punched Big Wilt Chamberlain in the blank. You know Tiny Willie Shoemaker? Tiny Willie.
All right, let's hustle along here.
Very good. Oh, Brett, aren't you clever to have done that so quickly?
Yes.
Your mind is growing by leaps and bounds.
Like a steel trap.
Okay.
Charles.
Come on, Charles. All right, we're all set now. Now, Chris Lyons, think about this. Tiny Willie Shoemaker got so mad, he punched Big Wilt Chamberlain in the blank.
Knee.
In the knee. I would think that's about how high he would be. Boom, hit him right in the knee there. What did you say, Orson?
Fortunately for Big Will, Tiny Willie was no bigger than the palm of your hand. He punched him in the knee.
He is a match for Chris there.
I had another answer, but I'm afraid too many people understand Italian.
I see. Brett, what did you say?
It's all right, I don't, Orson. I said Knees.
Knees. That's two for you, Chris. Charles.
I had him a little madder. He went all the way up to the nose.
Oh. How did he get to his nose?
You dummy.
His friends put him up to it.
Okay, now, because you've matched two and we've got three to go and she's got five, you must match the remaining three celebrities to stay in the game. We're looking for knees, my dear.
Looking for knees,
yeah.
Huh?
You've come to the right place.
And you found a knee.
There we found a knee. All right, sir.
Have a cure for water on the knee.
What is that?
Wear pumps.
Now you must match Betty White to achieve a tie. Let's see what you've got, Betty.
A friend in knee is a friend in
knee. So at this moment, it's tied up. Now, I say to you, Margaret Moore, one match will win the game for you. Only one. Here we go. Now, last time, you matched everyone except Orson. Mm. So, Orson, you are the only one who will participate in this. Are you ready?
And the rest of us will lay out.
The rest of you will lay out.
Right.
I'm going to have a quick sniff of my marking pen, and I'll be ready.
No, that's enough.
Where have you gone?
Here it is.
Yes.
How to get a man.
Yes. Your eyes are quite beautiful.
How to get a man to propose.
Yes.
One, tell him you love him.
Yes.
Two, tell him he's handsome.
Yes.
Three,
yes,
tell him you're blank. How to get a man to propose. There you are. How to get a man to propose.
Yes.
One, tell him you love him. Two, tell him he's handsome. Three, tell him you're blank.
How long have you been in this country, dear?
Now, Orson, write something down there. You're on your own. I'm not going to help you any more than that.
I tell you, he is finished, Margaret.
How to get a man to propose. One, tell him you love him. Two, tell him he's handsome. Three, tell him you're blank.
Willing.
Willing? Tell him you're willing.
Willing
who? Willing.
From a shoemaker.
It's a very Charles Dickens answer. Orson, she said willing. May we see your answer?
Please repeat the question.
Tell him he's handsome. Three, tell him you're...
a nymphomaniac.
I assume that is not a match, right? And I assume that means we go into a tiebreaker. Here this game ends in a tie. And we push the button to go to a tiebreaker, and we'll do that in a moment or so. But first, we've got to do a little bit of this.
For match game, the right answer is D, all of the above. Gene was also one of the first to do live morning radio. Back then, Gene's hair was longer than his now classic skinny microphone. Stay tuned for more of that 70s hour on GSN.
Okay, here we go now. We'll blank this score out here. Oh, it worked. Terrific. And
score.
We've got the tiebreaker up here. One question for each lady, and the one who has scored the most will be the winner. Chris, please make a selection.
A.
All right. Everybody plays in the tiebreaker.
Back in the game, Chris.
Bob and Carol and Ted and Alice all took a blank together. Bob and Carol. Ted and Alice all took a blank together. I love your bow tie.
Thank you.
Splendid. All right.
Modern paint.
Upper tier is ready. We're waiting for Miss Flo down there. She is. All right, Chris Lyons, Bob and Carol, and Ted and Alice all took a...
bath
together. You said a bath together. Orson, what did you say?
I'm sorry, I said a vacation.
A vacation together? Yes, really. Bath is hers. What's yours, Brett?
Well, you see, she jumped the gun.
What?
Well, you can't take a bath, by golly, till you take a room.
Well, they took a room together.
Ta-da!
Well, I thought everybody'd say bath on that. This surprises me. Charles?
I went to college. Ball.
Ball. Earlier. Do you have them bathing together?
Oh,
honey?
She's probably got them... Oh, I don't even want to think.
No, let her show and tell. Crocheting together?
When they're all through.
Yes.
I went to college and I said they took a room together.
They took a room together.
How do you think I feel, B?
Yes. Okay, Richard. Bath is what we are looking for.
You can't get four people in a bath.
You can't?
But
God knows I've tried. They took a swim together.
Took a swim together.
In the nudo, but
no,
you can't get them in
there.
A bath.
All right, Betty White.
You can if you have enough soap. Play hard, but play clean. They took a bath.
Bath together.
You have enough soap?
All right, so you got two for you. And Margaret, you need two to tie, three to win. And here we go.
Oh, dear.
The Texas millionaire said... I taught my baby his first word today. It was blank. Texas millionaire said that.
Would you repeat that, please?
I helped my baby to learn to speak the English language. He says, I taught my baby his first word today. It was blank. Texas millionaire said that, remember.
Why is Mary Ann so slow? Is it because she's from the South?
No, she has an impediment in her reach.
Everybody's ready.
I break my bones, but words will never hurt me.
Here we go. The Texas millionaire said, I taught my baby his first word today. It was...
oil.
Oil. Okay.
She's looking for a little oil there, Orson.
And I got a little oil for her.
All right, there's one match for you.
I'll give her a massage.
One more to tie and two to win, Brett.
You know, my friend Angelique, who's my children's godmother's from Texas.
Yeah.
And she was at one time very rich, and her daddy taught her the word money.
Money. All right, Charles.
The little baby said money.
Money. So far, only one gusher. What do you offer, Marianne?
All right, Brett.
Oh,
she said oil.
Oil.
Oh, what a devil.
Try your score. One more oil well, you win the game.
Well,
Richard?
I happen to know one thing that very wealthy Texans do.
What?
They say, check. Then they give it to you.
Hamburgers.
Okay. Now, if we don't get another oil well, we get another tie, Betty.
We got another tie because he taught her to say money.
Money. Okay.
There.
So that means I push the button again and we go to another tiebreaker. Shall we wipe the slate clean? We did that. All right, challenger, please make a selection.
A.
She wants A. Again, everybody plays. And again you play. Every Saturday night, Frank gets picked up by a blank. Every Saturday night. Frank gets picked up by a blank.
Every Saturday night. Every Saturday night. Frank gets picked up by a blank. And what happens to me? I'll tell you what happens to me. Nothing happens to me.
James Cagney.
They walk in that James Cagney.
Oh, drop your mouth.
Everybody ready?
Right.
Come on, I'm running out of
invitations. Everybody ready.
Listen, what do you say to this? Every Saturday night, Frank gets picked up by a...
Oh, sailor.
Sailor. You say sailor?
No.
I thought I heard her say sailor.
Yeah. No, she said marine.
No. She said sailor, and yeah, that's her answer, and that was the first thing we heard, and we've got to accept that. So, Orson, what do you say?
You could let her change it. I mean, the crowd really...
No, you can't let her change it because those are the rules.
All right, Frank gets picked up by a sailor.
Ah!
And he takes him dancing.
All right.
And they have a wonderful time. And he buys him a fried egg sandwich and he kisses him goodnight at the door. That's the story.
That's it. Okay. Yeah. Brett, what do you say?
Orson, of course, as usual, is wrong. Frank is a girl who was named after her daddy.
Yeah.
And she always went out and picked up a sailor.
Oh, I can't believe this. This is happening on this show. Charles.
I don't know if a sweet southern girl should hear all this. Darling, wait in your dressing room. Now, I said to be a little different.
Uh-huh.
Work. I said a lady of the streets, and she was really a Saint San Vicente. A lady of the street.
Okay, got the idea. So
he was a normal guy, is there something wrong?
Oh, Charles, you're too much.
All
right, Marianne Mobley, what do you say?
Well,
sailor's the answer that Chris Lyon's looking for. Every Saturday night, Frank gets picked up by a go.
Well, I was taught, sitting at home on the veranda, that one said...
Oh, I'm going to give her such a punch one of these days.
If that's part of my life, I'll help you.
One said what?
Picked up by a lady of the night.
A lady of the night. Okay.
Called a night crawler where I come from.
We need an answer from you. Sailor's the answer that Chris is looking for.
You know something, this little old darling here is just so sweet. She kisses you, you get diabetes.
Wait a minute, you disgust me. I said woman.
Woman.
The woman sailor.
No, madam.
Frankie and Johnny were sweethearts. I always thought that was just a song. No. Frankie was a vaudevillian with a very bad act. He got picked up by a hooker.
I see. Give her the hook.
Okay, so there were two sailors there, Chris.
Left out.
And that surprised me. And we'll get to yours, but first we've got to get to this and pull ourselves together. Here we go. Chris Lyons here has had her half of this tiebreaker, and she scored twice. And now we've got your half of the tiebreaker, and we'll see how you do. Is everyone ready?
Ready.
Yes. This is the second half of the tiebreaker.
Yes, okay.
Jane said, the only problem I have with my husband is that he lives in the blank. Jane said, the only problem that I have with my husband is that he lives in the blank. All right. Ready down here, Charles? Ready. So, we'll call on Margaret Moore. Jane said the only problem I have with my husband is that he lives in the...
garage.
In the garage? That's kind of an oddball answer. She said garage. Orson, let's see, you need two to tie and stay in the game. Three will win it. She said garage. What do you say?
If she thinks that's a problem, imagine the problem she'd have if he lived in the Y.
In the Y. That would be
he
bad.
He might never come home.
That's true. Brett?
I've heard that. That's where Jack Coughlin's living, in the Y. Hasn't been home in months. Well, the minute you said Jane, you see, I immediately thought of Tarzan, and I said trees.
In the trees. Okay, Charles. Garage, the answer we're looking
for. I said John, toilet, outhouse, or sailor.
Yeah, that's true. The only problem I have with my husband is that he lives in the...
bed, because he is so lazy.
Oh, really? Bed. Her answer is bed. You must match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game, Margaret. Here we go, Richard.
Well, unless the garage is named John, it's not a match.
Okay. Chris Lyons is the winner. Congratulations. There's $100 for you. Congratulations. Margaret Moore will be leaving here with $5,600 in our good wishes. We're going to turn it to and you know how it goes,
not
so shall we
Marianne.
Get right to it?
Okay.
All right, here we go. We're the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $5,000. We polled a recent studio audience, Chris, and we got their best response to this. Blank age. You know how it goes, $500, $250, and $100. Little help from celebrities. Name them one at a time.
Richard.
Something Gene and I are suffering from. Old age.
Speak for yourself, Sam.
Oh, I say you got old. Who else?
Charles.
And also, Ran, how about golden age?
Golden age. There's another one.
Yes. Keep the applause down, please.
Don't spread this around, but how about middle age?
Middle age. So now you have golden age,
in 10
old
years.
Age, and middle age. You may choose one of those as the answer or give us one of your own, but we have to call for a response now.
Old age.
Old age is what she thinks is the winner up there. The one that Richard gave her. Let's find out where it is. First, may we see the $100 response? Teenage is a marvelous answer that never came up at all, did it? Okay. Still looking for old age. Here is the $250 response.
Stone age.
Yeah, that's a very good crowd. Yeah, okay. Here's your last chance for old age, my dear. All right, your last chance for old age, I repeat. Here is the $500 response. Congratulations. Okay. You got the $500. You got to play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. You got to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay. He gets ready to write. You face me. Here is the $5,000 question. Please write your response to this. Blank world. Blank world. Okay, he's finished. Now, Chris, we need an answer from you. How do you fill in that blank? Blank world.
New world.
New world is what she said. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Six small world.
Small world.
Small world.
Okay, you got
got the $600. That's yours. You're still a champ. Going to play another game. But first, this message. Being our current champ, Chris Lyons, next time. And I am deeply in debt to all of these people because they gave us marvelous performances, energy, vitality, and all that.
I have one thing to say.
Splendid. What?
Charles Nelson Reilly isn't wearing socks.
Who asked you?
I asked the world.
Next time, we're going to have this group of kooks.
Bert Convy. Brett Somers. Dick Gaudier. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder.
Gene Rayburn from Mad Games 74. Join us next.